The future might already be written. Cheer, shudder, or eye roll in disgust. But history shows that what awaits us is often spelled out in the pages of science fiction. The genre's predictive track record stretches back thousands of years. Authors mused about the lunar landing as far back as 175 AD, when Syrian satirist Lucian of Samosata imagined flying ships to the moon, a tale that tapped the seafaring culture's desire to ascend to the heavens. Fiction isn't always pure fantasy, as Dan Rockmore, director of Dartmouth College's Neukom Institute for Computational Science, puts it, some of our greatest authors are not making up stuff whole cloth, but sampling from the zeitgeist, scientific or otherwise. Of course, scribes do have blind spots. They never quite nailed the smartphone. Easy Trekkies, those communicators are more like fancy pagers. Here's a glimpse of what sci-fi writers of the past got right. Inspired by galvanism, aka manipulating muscles with an electrical current, Mary Shelley's Dr. Victor Frankenstein famously reanimates dead flesh. In 1947, the less ghoulish Dr. Claude Beck saved a teenage patient with a 60 hertz jolt to the heart from his homemade defibrillator, two silver paddles wired to an outlet. By the 50s, the machines were reviving patients in hospitals worldwide. In Edward Everett Hale's 1869 novella, The Brick Moon, four friends from college use a river-powered flywheel to sling a skyscraper-sized brick sphere stuffed with people into orbit. The Soviet Union's Salyut program launched a 65-foot cylinder, the seminal space station, in 1971. The crew snapped photos of Earth and experimented with gamma rays and a secret military radiometer. Today, there's only one space station orbiting the planet, the International Space Station, where astronauts from around the world conduct experiments in a microgravity environment. However, several countries and private companies have plans to build and launch their own stations in the coming decades. Characters in Samuel Butler's 1872 novel Erewhon realize computers were ultimately destined to supplant the race of man, so they banned smart gizmos. Real robots have been learning to outdo us since the 1950s, when AI researchers held a workshop at Dartmouth. IBM's Arthur Samuel coded a checkers player that refined its approach until it could beat him. In 2016, Google's AlphaGo program beat a human professional for the first time in the ancient Chinese board game Go. A year later, the AI's successor beat the number one player in the world. In her 1880 short story Mizora, Mary Bradley Lane describes Amazonians who transform beef's chemical elements into synthetic burgers. She calls it a more economical way of obtaining meat than by fattening animals. Lane wasn't far off. Dutch scientist Mark Post's petri-born patty starts as bovine stem cells. In 2013, the first one cost more than $280,000 to grow, but he's since trimmed that to around $12. In Rokeya Sakawat Hossein's 1905 story Sultana's Dream, a female-led utopia has made many scientific advances, including saving summer sun to warm a town through winter. After decades of small-scale projects in Nordic nations, that dream turned real in 2007. At the Drake Landing Solar Community in Alberta, Canada, 800 solar thermal collectors generate energy in the form of heat. That energy can either be held in short-term storage and used to warm homes, or moved to long-term storage during the hotter months. The novel Tom Swift and His Electric Rifle details a boy inventor whose blaster stuns targets with the powerful current of stored electricity. That idea sounded neat to NASA engineer Jack Cover, whose TASER is an acronymic reference to that 1911 novel. It stands for Thomas A. Swift's Electric Rifle. The weapon he patented in 1974 conducts a jolt of juice from a battery through a pair of leads into the target's nervous system. Ray Bradbury famously wanted to prevent dystopian futures, not predict them. But one tiny piece of tech in 1953's Fahrenheit 451 hit a non-fiction tipping point. Thimble radios, which provided an electronic ocean of sound, of music, and talk. The next year, Texas Instruments debuted the first mass-market portable radio, complete with a single earphone. Since then, several technologies have gained and lost popularity. Boomboxes, CD players, MP3 players, and the smartphone. What's your favorite piece of tech straight out of sci-fi? Is there something we forgot to include on this list? Let us know in the comments below, and read more about sci-fi gadgets turned reality at popsci.com.